This is Rick with Magic City Streetcars. We got Mike with Muscle Car Club of Billings. We're here at the Rendezvous at the show and cruise that every Saturday night that the Muscle Car Club puts on. So take a look around. We got a lot of beautiful cars, a lot of good people out. So make sure you come out every Saturday night and see what the Muscle Car Club does. So I'm sitting here on our last episode. I talked about Craig Rakowski. Of course, I did say Paco, too, didn't I? Where did Paco come from, Craig?
Just the word that Terry calls me. Everybody thinks I'm Mexican, so Terry started calling me Paco.
Okay, so it's Neubauer again. Yeah. Oh, boy, he sure comes up a lot in these
sure stirs episodes. The shit pot.
He does. So, Craig, I want to talk to you about last year, right? Last year, you didn't race until that very last race.
Yeah.
Right? And you came out and you had to go up against Matt, and I believe it was Matt twice.
Yeah.
And you pushed your Chevelle all the way to number 9 for the first time, first night.
Yeah.
Now, in that night, what comes out to you as the best time that you had that night?
Well, it's definitely different. I mean, I haven't raced the Chevelle in probably 4 or 5 years, and so I was the first night I brought it out. I was determined to get on the list, and she wasn't running as good as I wanted to run, you know, but I was pretty proud of the results after sitting for 5 years in my garage. Can't go wrong there.
So sat for 5 years, and you bring it out, and you take it all the way to at least to number 9.
Yeah.
And did it quite quickly, too, if I remember correctly.
Yeah.
So, you know, out of that, on that night, let's go back to that night. What is probably the worst moment that you had in that night? Was it a thought? Was it a worry? Was it who you were racing?
Well, the worst part was trying to get back in the qualifying to get on the top 10 list. I had to do a bunch of qualifying passes, and I was worried I wasn't going to get on the qualifying. And then once I was qualified, in one of the races, I was racing for number 9, number 8 spot against Adam Ullman, and the tree was all messed up, and they kept pulling me back, and I ended up being in reverse when the light turned green, so.
Oh, no.
I almost caught him that time, though, so. No more reverse.
No more reverse in the green, on yep. The green, right? Yeah, that would be something that would I'd probably not like, too. So, great. You know, I always, before I do an interview, I kind of go through and learn what I can about each racer. And I kind of learned something about you that you're kind of old friends with someone that this community lost a few years back, about 6 years ago. You know, he was a big person in the racing community for Billings and did a lot. And everything that's going on now is a vision that he had 6 years ago. And that was Josh Whitcomb, right?
Yeah.
You were pretty good friends with the guy. And from what I knew about him, he was pretty good.
Oh, yeah.
What kind of influence did Josh have on you?
Always got to be faster.
Always got to be faster.
No, he was big in the racing scene. You know, this was his dream. You know, he wished he could be here today. I mean, he helped me build my car a lot of the ways. And he helped with a lot of friends, you know. Josh was a pretty big influence on racing. He was always trying to get me out there, and I always went out there all the time and raced, or watched him race. Mm-hmm.
Now, he had a nickname, and it was well earned, if I remember correctly. His nickname was King of the Streets, right?
Yeah.
And that was well earned, wasn't it?
Oh yeah.
What did he? What kind of car did he have?
He had many different cars.
Many different cars?
Anything from sleepers to race cars. I mean, he definitely knew how to build them, and he could race them, and he knew a lot about turbos, especially. And
he had an ear for the sound of a motor, didn't he?
Yeah.
He'd come by my house, I remember one time, and my truck was running like crap, and it was a Mopar.
Well, that's why.
That's why, right. It was a Mopar. And he sat there and he listened to it for a minute, and he went, I know what it is. And he twisted two screws, and it ran better. So I knew he had an ear for it. And he did. He had a lot of followers. He had a lot of people that respected him. A lot of people feared him on the street because of what he had. Is that right?
Yeah.
And he well earned the King of the Streets. So, Josh, you're well missed. We know you're watching, right?
Yeah, wish you were here to watch all this.
And this is something that you kind of had a vision of, and it's here. It took 6 years, but we got it. So. That's great. You know, he's well missed, and he will always be. I want to talk to you now about this year's list. Okay, who do you think is going to be in that top five, and who do you think is not going to make it?
In the top five, it's hard to say. A lot of people have done a lot of changes this summer or this winter. You know, and I'm not sure if I'll be racing, but too many things I got to do to my car still. But I'm sure it's going to be at least. I know Chad's going to be number one, of course.
Wait a minute now. Oh, that's right. You're WTP number 7, right?
Yeah.
White Trash Performance number 7. So that's okay. We know that one. Where do you think Neibauer's going to land?
I think he'll definitely be in the top 5 for sure.
Yeah.
Kind of got kicked off last year off the lit on from 2nd to 3rd, you know, but he'll definitely be in the top 2 or 3.
Is he coming back with a vengeance?
Well, I'm sure he will.
Yeah? We all know Neibauer. He'll come back with a vengeance.
Yeah.
So, is there anyone, you know, this year we've got grudge racing. Is there anyone you want to call out for a grudge?
Not off the top of my head. I got to wait till I get the car going on.
Not off the top of your head? Are you sure?
I think Sam's wanting me to call him out, though.
Sam wants you to call him out?
Yeah.
So, you're going to grudge Sam Hicks.
But see, by the time I get my car on the track, he might already broke his shit again. So.
Does he have strong enough lugs is what we want to know, okay?
Maybe all right. If he puts Chevy engine in there, then he might be on the list by the time I get back up there. So.
Sweet.
Let's have sweet.
So we have a grudge, right? All right, so you've called out Sam. We'll find out what his answer is in a couple of episodes down the road. You were saying, Craig, that you're not sure if you're going to be out this year, okay?
Yeah.
They do have an 11-6 bracket that's coming out that'll be on the same nights. So keep that in mind. Because I got a feeling your Chevelle could be right there at the top.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
So
it might run 12, so we'll see.
All right. Now, the last thing I got to ask you is, you made a prediction last week to me, okay? And that prediction needs to get out there. And you're looking at me like, what the hell did I say?
Yeah, I don't remember that.
Now, this guy, this gentleman, you can see right here where it says, he predicted that the Raiders are going to go to the Super Bowl this year. And if they do, I'll come and shake your hand. All right?
Do more than that.
So, we've come down to the point where I talk about our next episode, okay? Our next episode is going to be kind of a treat. What we're doing is we're going to pull together those racers that tried for the list and didn't make it, those that were on the list and broken, had to leave the list, and those that are shooting for the list this year. And I kind of got their names here, so I'm going to read them off a little bit. And so you guys be ready. We're going to meet in one place. It's going to be all of you together, sitting around a table, no holds barred, and let's see how it goes from there. So, that list is Mr. Brett Cole, Wes Nelson, Matt Boyce, Nina Johnson, John Beckner, and Tim Oilo. Tim Oilo. So,
I think it's Oli.
We were talking, I talked with a couple of them, and there was one other person that was on the list, and he left the list. I think we just talked about it. He kind of kissed the wall. And that's Mr. Sam Hicks. So we're going to definitely have Mr. Sam Hicks out there also, talking on this little round table. So be prepared for that. Craig, thank you, sir, for coming out.
Yep, thank you.
This is Rick with Magic City Streetcars, Mike with Muscle Car Club of Billings, and last year's number 9, Craig Rakowski. We'll see you on the next episode.